Hi everybody, from Papa TV, this is Patty Williams. Welcome you to another English edition of this week's news. Renovations of the main square in Papa have been temporarily halted after human remains were uncovered. It was also discovered that the soil in that area will need to be replaced in order to hold the weight of the pavement that is planned for that part of the square. Planners estimate they will have to dig down 0.5 meter to refill with firmer soil. Archaeologists from the Vesprent County Museum, together with the National Office of Cultural Heritage, are planning to come to an agreement concerning the continuation of excavations this week. Also, part of the city center reconstruction is the renovation of the former town hall buildings on Main Street. Roofing has been renewed as well as painting and renovations to the corridors between the cellars. According to architect Shava Nemeth, the old roof was unable to be salvaged, so they had to tear it down and build a completely new one. As part of the renovation, the courtyards of the building will be connected. The next big step will be the facade of the buildings. The renovation will be finished in middle to late summer. Last week, a temporary Holocaust exhibition was on display at the Papa train station. It was housed in a goods wagon that was used to deport Jewish to Auschwitz in 1944. On tour since 2007, an estimated 89,000 people have viewed the exhibition. Mayor Dr. Tamás Aldozó greeted in the arrival of the exhibition in Papa and emphasized that the Holocaust wasn't just the Jewish people's tragedy, but a Hungarian tragedy as well. More than 2,000 residents of Papa were deported, including young children and elderly. On Saturday, March 31st, a Baroque festival was held in the Esterházy Castle's garden. Singers, musicians, dancers, and flag twirlers entertained the crowd. After the Baroque ceremony, children were able to enjoy the playhouse. There were also tours of the museum halls, which were renovated in 2011. According to Mayor Dr. Tamás Aldozó, the city was applied feedback received in previous years and hopes that permanent programs in the following years will reflect castle's visitors' wants and needs. Last Tuesday morning, students from the Shokai Kindergarten gave an Easter performance for the Tebeli Uti Elders House. Relationships between generations have developed in past years among the Elders House and the kindergartens of Papa. This year, the children took part in the Hungarian Easter tradition of sprinkling and poem reading. They also handed out bouquets of flowers. In return, they received chocolates. These gatherings are loved by elders and children alike and take place on special days such as Easter, Christmas, St. Nicholas Day, Mother's Day, and Children's Day. The Sabaria Symphonic Orchestra treated Papa primary and secondary school students to a selection of music from the Arabian Nights. According to chorus master Miklos Sugar, this performance was special because it allowed the children to simultaneously watch scenes from the Arabian Nights while listening to the music being performed. The orchestra puts great importance on making the experience enjoyable for children because they hope to keep younger generations interested in classical music. On the last day of school before spring break, Petőfi Sándor Secondary Grammar School held a student day. This year, the festivities were organized by the 11B class. The day was open with teachers dancing to popular ABBA song Mamma Mia, which had most students joining in at the end. It was unquestionably the highlight of the day. Students were also treated to other activities such as egg painting and police demonstrations. Awards were handed out to both teachers and students in categories such as funniest teacher and cleverest student. The program ended with a teacher-student soccer match and class 12B took home the win. Papa native Ferenc Mazi has an exhibition of artwork currently on display at the Jokaj Mor Cultural Center. Born and raised in Papa, he currently lives in Szombathely, where he teaches and creates art. The exhibition of both colorful and black and white works is Ferenc's first in Papa and can be viewed until May 6. And now we have John Witters with this week's local weather.
Welcome to this week's weather forecast. I'm John Witters. This week will be cloudy with a maximum temperature of 14 to 17 degrees Celsius and a minimum temperature of 3 to 7 degrees Celsius. Unfortunately, it will rain frequently and the sky will be cloudy, but the wind shouldn't cause significant problems as it won't be too strong. Dress warmly because the weather is tricky and you can easily catch a cold. Also drive cautiously as the roads may be slippery. Please join me for more weather next week.
Thank you, John. A reminder that on April 14th, the International Community of Papa will be holding its first annual Spring 5K Fun Run. Participation is free, but monetary donations will be accepted for local children's charities. The event begins at 9 a.m. Children are also encouraged to participate and will run a shorter route. Participants will be provided water and medical care by the organizers. The first 150 participants will get a t-shirt and the best runners in all categories will be awarded. This event is open to everyone and is organized by the City of Papa, the Heavy Airlift Wing, the NATO Airlift Management Agency, and Boeing. For more information, please contact Heavy Airlift Wing Public Affairs Officer Anne Lee at +36 30 857 5587. Also, on Saturday, April 14th, come watch Lombard Papa take on Szombathely Hadash, and you will also be treated to a flyover of a Papa Airbase C-17. The match begins at 6 p.m. and be sure to wear your yellow and blue to support the team. From Papa TV, make sure to check us out next week. This is Patty Williams. Thank you for watching.